I don't get out of this, I just want you to know that I really, really love you.
Got a GD game to play, so let's get this GD thing going. I was like, didn't quite know how to take that, but you know, being from a Baptist background,
you know, how many times have you had your kids walk up to you and they say, "Oh no, don't mess with Daddy right now." That's the kind of attitude that you wanted to bring, and that's the kind of lifestyle that I wanted to lead. Everyone would say, "Ronnie, how could you go off like that?" And then sit down and say, "Okay, let's pray." I'm almost positive that the Lord has forgiven me because he understands that there's only a couple of ways to get people's attention. And sometimes you gotta go over the top. It's nothing but pure, pure love for the game of football. The transformation of wanting to be great, I wouldn't trade it for anything. They were attention, and sometimes I wanted to leave.
Being from a Baptist background,
you know, how many times have you had your kids walk up to you and they say, "Oh no, don't mess with Daddy right now." That's the kind of attitude that you wanted to bring, and that's the kind of lifestyle that I wanted to lead. Everyone would say, "Ronnie, how could you go off like that?" And then sit down and say, "Okay, let's pray." I'm almost positive that the Lord has forgiven me because he understands that there's only a couple ways to get people's attention. And sometimes you got to go over the top. It's nothing.
Being from a Baptist background,
you know, how many times have you had your kids walk up to you and they say, "Oh no, don't mess with Daddy right now." That's the kind of attitude that you wanted to bring, and that's the kind of lifestyle that I wanted to lead. Everyone would say, "Ronnie, how could you go off like that?" And then sit down and say, "Okay, let's pray." I'm almost positive that the Lord has forgiven me because he understands that there's only a couple ways to get people's attention. And sometimes you gotta go over the top. It's nothing but pure, pure love for the game of football.
Come across in the meeting.
Dallas Cowboys,
America's team,
and we got them.
Who was next?
I'd say not really. And we win the game. We score 38 points, and we're going on to the NFC Championship game. Did it matter who was next? I'd say not really, but I'd be lying. We wanted the Cowboys, and we got them. The Dallas Cowboys,
America's team.
Tom Landry,
the darling of the NFL.
The organization.
Too arrogant.
Arrogant.
"We're gonna kill him!"
They pissed us off.
They were to us everything and everybody that had just stomped on us for 3 or 4 years.
We're gonna kill the Cowboys.
That's what was going on that week.
I was thinking about it. They say Rose Bowl's the granddaddy of them all, but being here, it's overcoming that. This might be the great, great granddaddy right now.
As I was going through that game, I did start to get the feel, wow, this is awesome. You know, the back and forth of it. All the turnovers. We had 6 turnovers that game.
You beat a team, but you still turn the ball over 6 times? That just doesn't happen. Just think of what that game's like if you take those 6 turnovers away.
White going back to pass, throws it down the middle, and it is caught and into the end zone for a touchdown as Cosby changing the upper hand of that scoreboard for the 5th time today.
And they mark the ball down at the San Francisco 11. That's how far they have to go to win.
At that time, half the team had been sick and had the flu, and so we were all just exhausted and worn out.
Dead tired. And I get into the huddle in the biggest drive of my life, and I'm throwing up in the huddle.
Which was nasty.
Guys were saying, oh, get out of here. Yeah, and maybe it was some comic relief. I don't know.
This feels impossible. America's team, 89 yards to win the game. I mean, this is when Dallas is great. But Joe comes in the huddle, just has that look on his face.
Looks up and says, we're going to go down, we're going to score a touchdown, we're going to win this game, and we're going to stick it in their ear.
With the Cowboys expecting Montana to pass, Bill Walsh decided to play smash-mouth football.
The play calling on that whole drive was incredible. It was just the greatest chess match of all time.
Look who's making the big plays. You know, Linville Elliott, former Cincinnati Bengal halfback, who was cut in the preseason and then resigned, is running left on 18 Bob. He's running right on 18 Bob.
Unusual call, but effective. Crossing up the Cowboys.
We still got the feeling that, wow, we got them off balance. And then they were pursuing so hard, Bill comes up with the great call of the reverse.
Z reverse.
And the running play.
About the time that we thought we were going to run it, we would throw it.
First down, he throws to the sideline, and it is caught by Clark at the 25. It goes out of bounds. A brilliant throw and catch.
Linville Elliott's final carry brought the ball to the 6-yard line. The next play would mark the end of one dynasty and the birth of another.
We're going to call a sprint option. Break up and break into the corner.
Okay, you got it?
Dwight will clear.
Dwight is in here sliding back out. This is great when they're tired and they're confused and they want to get back to Dallas. This is when you knock their ass off.
If you don't get what you want, you'll just simply throw the ball away. Okay. Not there, the way you go. You're ready to go to Dwight, you got it?
There wasn't a doubt in our mind that we were going to score on Dallas. They knew that they couldn't stop us. You only had to look across the line of scrimmage to know that. We had Joe.
Who is this guy, Montana? I'm John Wayne. I'm John Wayne. And John Wayne never loses. I'm making this throw.
So fasten your seatbelts now. We've got turbulence and plenty of it here in Candlestick Park.
How is this one going to end? Montana lines up at the 5. And on 3rd down and 3, he rolls right, looking to throw. Looking to throw, and
that goes back now to the improv, to what Joe brought to the offense. And it goes back to that chemistry of the two guys we thought were basketball players when they got there, Joe and Dwight, to what they could do together. I don't think Dwight...
Humbling, really. I feel honored. People are still talking about it 25 years later. I don't know if that's true.
Effort. Tremendous.
Clay Clark has it. It's a touchdown for the 49ers.
I've been told that there was a poor Asian kid born on the January 10th, 1982, and his name is Dwight Clark Mitamuzo. So I don't know if that's true, but for his sake, I hope not. But that's quite an honor if it is true. It's humbling, really. I feel honored people are still talking about it 25 years later.
It's called the sprint right option.
I'm honored to be able to be a part of a play that was kind of the culmination of just this incredible surprise season. It's great to give 49er fans that moment that they can relive over and over and over, and I know they do, because when I'm in San Francisco or a lot of places, people want to talk about that play, how it crushed the Cowboys and sent them into submission for a decade. I never get tired of talking about it. I never get tired of seeing it. Because I, you know, sign pictures and send them to people, I see that catch every day. I may sit and think about that moment, you know, a couple times a year, and, you know, how awesome it was to be a part of, to be a part of that play and be a part of the 49ers in, you know, the 80s. I mean, it's hard to get any better than that.
There will never be Disneyland like that in my life again.
It was a day I wish my son could have.
Absolut unglaublich. Toll gemacht. Ganz toll.
Also los, Jungs, setzen wir diese Änderungen um. Aktiviert. Du kannst es in der DRS-Zone verwenden, wenn du weniger als eine Sekunde. sagen. Auf der Strecke ist kaum was los. Jede Menge Platz. Also los, Jungs, setzen wir diese Änderungen um. Solltest du rausfahren. Im Moment ist es ziemlich ruhig auf der Strecke.
Ja.
Straße. nicht die weiße Linie überfährt, sonst gibt es eine Strafe. Wir fahren gleich raus. Mach dich bereit.
Thank you.
14 Punkte.
Stell dir vor, du hast plötzlich zwei Mobilfunknetze. Zwei sind stärker. Zwei sind schneller.